Well, Matthew Price has travelled from Transylvania and joins me live now from Sofia in Bulgaria. Matthew, you make the point in your piece that this migration of thousands of Romanians towards Europe has in reality been going on for years, and it's difficult to know whether it's really going to accelerate come January.
It's very difficult to know. Back in 2001, visa restrictions, broadly speaking, were lifted on Bulgarians and Romanians. In 2007, they joined the European Union. And during those years, and ever since, of course, the collapse of communism here, people have taken advantage of the opportunities they've had to leave these countries and to travel west and look for better wages and better opportunities. But I've met quite a lot of people in Romania and also spoken to some here in Bulgaria who are really quite offended by the tone of the debate in Britain, especially over this whole issue. I'd like to bring in at this point member of the European Parliament for Bulgaria, Svetoslav Malinov. Can I ask, I mean, you'll be well aware of the tone of that debate in Britain. A lot of the newspapers talking about a potential flood of Bulgarians coming in, stealing from the welfare system. Do you think that's going to happen?
Well, I'm not offended exactly. If I have to use a better word, I'm very disappointed that even the Prime Minister of Britain has included himself in that debate. Of course, I don't believe anything of these things will happen. Bulgaria has been a member of the European Union for several years. We have all these rights concerning other countries. Bulgarians have been traveling even to find a better job in other countries, and there have never been these problems, and they will never happen in Britain again.
Do you think the tone of the debate in Britain, are you finding a similar debate in other countries across Europe? I know a lot of Bulgarians have gone to Spain, Italy, Germany.
Well, probably each of these countries has this kind of moment when they were kind of too eager, they were afraid of all these new people finding jobs in their countries. But all of these debates are now not active. It seems that in Britain it starts now, and maybe there are some reasons in domestic policy for that.
And you yourself here in Bulgaria are having problems with immigration from the Middle East at the moment, aren't you?
Yes, for the first time in decades, there is something that we call a refugee wave for Bulgaria. We are trying to cope with that. We are learning how to do that because we haven't had this experience in the last decades. But we have some experience before, and when we see these communities that actually joined Bulgaria decades ago, and we see how well integrated are, what their contribution to Bulgarian economy and culture, we know that we'll manage this time too.
And just briefly, on a European perspective, we saw the large numbers of people arriving in the Italian island of Lampedusa from Africa and the Middle East. Europe promising to deal with its immigration problem, its refugee problem. Do you think Europe is getting on top of the problem?
Well, I believe that we need more solidarity among European states. We see that this is a problem, especially for some countries like Cyprus, Greece, Italy, Bulgaria at the moment. And I believe that we have to have some new concept of solidarity and also some new rules in order to help countries, especially inexperienced countries like Bulgaria. I'm not ashamed to say that.
All right. Well, thank you very much for joining us here on the BBC's Svetoslav Malinov, European parliamentarian for Bulgaria. The migration debate is not just one, as you just heard, in Britain. It's right the way across this continent at the moment, and it is exercising the minds of an awful lot of politicians in national capitals. Back to you.
Indeed it does. The debate rages on. Matthew, many thanks. Matthew Price.